Okay, our today's topic is industrial control system. Industrial control system. It is an important topic for you guys. So, first of all, let's see what is a basic control system. It is an automatic controller compares the actual value of the plant output with desired value, determines the deviation, and produces a control signal which will reduce the deviation to zero or to a small value. The manner in which the automatic controller produces the control signal is called the control action. Okay. So let me tell you it again. An automatic controller compares the actual value of the plant output with desired value. The automatic controller compares the actual value. Actual value, see, that is the actual value of the plant output with desired value. Determines the deviation and produces a control signal which will reduce the deviation to zero or to a small value. Okay. The manner in which the automatic controller produces the control signal is called the control action. So you can see that what I'm trying to tell you here, that see, you have a control system here and you have a feedback. Okay, say that is plus, that is minus, so that is RS, that is CS, that is the control system. Okay, so here it compares the input with the feedback. Okay, if it is zero, then output will get the desired output. The manner in which the automatic controller produces the control signal called the control action. Okay. Okay, so industrial control system, we can classify it in six types. We can classify the industrial control system in six types. Two position or on-off controller, proportional controller, integral controller, proportional plus integral control, that means the PI controller, proportional plus derivative control, that is the PD controller, proportional plus derivative plus integral control, that means PID controller. So there are PID and PI controller, PD controller, and PID controller. These are the types. So how many types there are? There are six types. Okay. So six types of controller. Six types of controller are there. Okay. So PI, PD, PID. PID. Total six types of controllers are there. Okay, we'll see one by one. Okay, now see, elements of an industrial automatic controller. What are the elements? You see, an automatic controller must detect the error. So it should detect the error. It should detect the error. It must detect the error. Comparator may be used for this purpose. We can use the comparator for this purpose. An automatic controller must detect the error. Comparator may be used for this purpose. The controller normally operates at low voltage and low power level. So amplifier is required. So we need the amplifier. Okay. Because it works at the low voltage and the low power level. So amplifier is required. And the measuring element measures the control variable of the plant. Okay, the control variable. See, this is the actuator to actuator. Controller amplifier output goes to the actuator. And measuring element goes to the error detector. The visiting element measures the control variable of the plan. It measures the control variable of the plan. So that is the block diagram. Okay, that is the block diagram of automatic controller. That is the block diagram of automatic controller. So it is the total scenario. And the automatic controller, what it will do? Must detect the error. Comparator may be used for this purpose. The controller normally operate at low voltage and low power levels. Amplifier is required. Two position or on off control action. See, two position or on off control action. What it is? This controller is very simple. In express sign and widely used for industries and domestic applications. So, it is used in industries and domestic applications. It was the error signal to produce the control action. The controller produces MT from the input error signal ET. The two levels on off signal is produced by the controller with say MT. MT is equal to M1 for ET error is greater than zero, and MT is M2 for error is less than zero. These are the two levels. Okay. So this is the M1 and this is the M2. M1 lower level, M2 higher level. Okay, it is the output. So error. Two levels without differential gap is used. Okay. Just a minute. Okay, so where are we? It is the reference input. Okay, it is the level M1 level, it is the M2 level. Two levels with the differential gap is used. Okay. So we can use the differential gap also. A differential gap or hysteresis is used to avoid frequent switching. We can use the hysteresis to avoid the frequent switching. Yeah, okay. And see the proportional controller. What is the proportional controller? The proportional controller MT is equal to KPET, or the output of the controller is proportional to the input. So it is the proportional controller KP. We have already seen it in the chapter 7. By using the Laplace transform, MS by ES is equal to proportional controller is equal to KP. The problem of this controller is if it is zero, MT is also zero. That is the problem. This controller requires steady state error to operate. So it requires an error. It provides no delay, and a steady state error can be reduced to a very low value by selecting high input value of KP. Okay. Integral controller, it integrals the error to produce the output. So if you integrate the error, then you will get the output. Okay, integral or KI. It introduces a pole at the origin. So it will introduce a pole at the origin. It is a slow controller as it integrates the error. It produces a ramp output with the step error input and parabolic output with the ramp error input. So it produces ramp output with the step error input and parabolic output with the ramp error input. Okay. These are the feature. These are the feature of the integral controller. Okay, so what is the derivative controller? What are the features here? It differentiates the error signal to produce the output. It differentiates the error signal to produce the output. It converts a step error to impulse output, ramp error to step output, and parabolic error to ramp output. The controller produces first response. The controller generates zero at the origin. So it is the function. These are the features of the derivative controller. It differentiates the error signal to produce output. MT. DAT, DT. MS, KDS, CS. It converts a step error to impulse output, ramp error to step output, and parabolic error to ramp output. Yes. The controller produces first response. The controller generates zero at the origin. Okay, it is a derivative controller. So another one, important one, the PI controller. Okay. It is the most widely used controller. PI controller we do use most widely, and it combines the benefits of both proportional and integral controller. Proportional, it has the benefits over proportional and integral controller. This is the proportional controller, this is the integral controller. Okay, so if we take it, if we Laplace transform this one, then we'll get this one. It introduces a pole and a zero to the controller system. It introduces a pole and zero to the controller system. Okay, so it is the equation of the PI controller. Now PD controller. Okay, so the output of the PD controller is, this is the output of the PD controller, and it induces zero and is used in applications to very fast control system. It will introduce zero and is to used in applications for very fast control systems. Okay, it introduces zero and is used in applications for very fast control system. Okay, this is the PD controller. And PID controller, this is the most versatile form of controller, and it combines the features of these controller components. Okay, it introduces two zeros and a pole. Two zeros and a pole. So final output of this controller is this one. Okay, empty. Here see PID, three components are there. So that is the that is another kind of controller, PID controller. Okay, so this is the end of this chapter. This is the industrial control system. Okay, let me share another thing with you. PID controller, I think you get here this book, Ogata Modern Control System, 5th edition, Katsuhiko Ogata. In this book, you also get these things. Okay, from this book. Let me check. Mathematical modeling. Transient first order system. PID controller, different chapter. But mathematical modeling, decorative introduction, no, these are not. Conversation analysis designed by the root locus method. Okay, root locus method is another important thing. I have to show this to you. And other things like board plot, polar plot, log magnitude, okay. These two things we'll also discuss. PID controller and modified PID controllers. PID is the important one because it does, we used it in the industrial systems. Okay. Okay, so in the status space control system design, no need for this time being. In status space, PID controller, lead lag. Likely this chapter 7. Okay, we'll see few things from this book. Okay, like root locus things, chapter 6, chapter 7. Okay, let's look at the chapter 8, 5, 6, 7. They have given the MATLAB functions there. See, PID controller. Previous PID controllers and modified PID controllers. Okay, see this PID controller system. Okay, we can introduce a PID controller in front of the plant so that output can be modified. See, But in the previous chapters, I think they have discussed the PID controllers. See, like this, some controls, some extra thing has been used, okay, to control the system, to control the output. Okay, we have used some extra things. In this chapter, previous chapters, state space representation, automatic control, state space, mathematical modeling mechanism, electrical system, hydraulic system, transient, chapter 6. Okay. Also, if you look at this chapter, this book, Norman S. Nice book, here you also get the industrial control system idea. Let me show you which chapter. Time response, we have completed the chapter 7. 8 is 8 remains, 9 remains. Frequency response technique, stability, gain margin, controller, digital control modeling, the digital computer, set response stability, controller design. See, controller design, this controller thing at their lead lag. Okay. We have to check these things later. Chapter 8, we have to check the design by root locus. And chapter 8, we have to check the chapter 8. And I would not check the chapter 9, rather I'd check the chapter 10. The chapter 10 will see the board plots. Board plots are important. Gain margin, phase margin, those things, stability. Okay, those things will be there. And chapter 11, lay lag compensation. These things will introduce you the PID controller. These things. Okay, these things will introduce you the PID controller. Then the controller design C. Let's look at the 665. These are the board plots. This is called the board plots. Okay. Late compensation. Lead lag. Lead lag compensation. Okay, we'll check this later. We do not have very much things. We have a root locus and a board plot. Okay, two more chapters we have to complete. Okay, then we can check the lab later. Okay, after that we can check the lab. See, this is the MATLAB output. Okay. Using the MATLAB, we can find this thing, this type of output. Okay. Or you can control the antenna, how to control the antenna. Okay. You can also check this one. Case studies, this is a case study. Okay. These things are there. Okay, I am stopping here.